next, a dear old friend of ours. Oh, Michael will have his feature January here. And before January is December. And Eva Strausser, who is going to work her way up to the podium, is going to be featured in December. This is our Christmas present. So, without further ado, Ms. Strausser.
Thank you. And I'm going to be doing Christmas poetry also, so I'm trying to make it for December. My first poem is called When You Leave. When you leave, don't forget to shut the door. Don't worry about your key, because the new lock won't be a fit, and the welcome mat will be pulled. Careful not to slip. When you pack, take the photos, leave the frames. If you see old friends, no need to mention my name. Don't forget your toothbrush and toothpaste. I don't want your DNA left behind. Once you're gone, you'll be far from my mind. When you book your flight, make it one way. Nonstop's the fastest way to go. When you miss your connection, remember it was me who told you so. So as it is Friday the 13th, I came armed with two kind of creepy like poems, and the first one is called Insane, and it was actually inspired by a friend who swore that a fake rubber tree plant was growing. So, very crazy. So it's called Insane, and it goes like this. I hear a conversation, yet he's alone in the room. Barely alive or nearly dead, too much activity in his head. I ask, who are you talking to? He responds, no one. I must be going insane. Tell me, what do they look like? Does he or she have a name? Sounds like he's going insane. Laughing out of context, crying for no reason, having chats with visions in chairs, dark shadows on the ceiling. He's asking, how do you do? I look up simultaneously, but they won't talk to me. Fog on the windows, black vultures in the house, puddles on the linoleum. Open the door, let them all in. It's raining, now it's snowing. In truth, it's a perfect sunny day. A one-sided conversation until they fade away. A belt to hold his pants up, the fake rubber plant, it's growing, doubling in size. He says, this toast tastes like pizza. Offer everyone a slice. He's tap, tap, tapping his music, his foot to music. It sounds so nice, a pleasant thing to do, except the radio broke last June. He's in chains, each link earned. Medications don't help him forget all his new friends. He's offering them advice, becoming paranoid, provoking intruders in his head, unbalanced and unstable. A brain gone askew. A furry gray blanket is a cat, goes dancing to entertain him, women speaking in tongues. They're out morning to night, hidden in plain sight. That pinch on the shoulder, those alarm bells in your head, once they disappear, he'll be all alone again. Thank you. And finally, for tonight, I am going to attempt to read everyone in this room's fortune. And I think I have a 99% chance of success. This is called, Is It What I See or What I Wish to Be? And it goes like this. I have a vision. One of you will make a successful missionary. Another seated amongst us has the structure to be a politician. One of you is destined to become famous. I should ask for your John Hancock in advance. The gypsy within me sees travel ahead. One of you will be taking a plane, another by train, and I see someone will soon purchase a new vehicle. American made, by the way. I'd like to share that I predict someone sitting in the rear will be married within 3 years. Frequent places that give you great peace. That is indeed where she will be. Your vows will be written to perfection. Your bride will wear a custom-made white gown. She will bear you a daughter whom you will give a dramatic name, Juliet, or one of you. Power of suggestion, perhaps a gentle nudge, to guide you in the right direction. I know what you're thinking. I can see beyond today. So hold your tongue, no questions, please. A prophet, I am not. You may still want to listen to me, however, when I say, I sense friendship amongst where you sit. I wouldn't be a hypocrite if I were to be correct in declaring the night will be dark, the sun tomorrow will appear, and a holiday is on the horizon. Nostradamus? Not exactly. Yet I can clearly see a gentleman amongst us will put glasses on when he reads this evening, and someone else looks to be a female, gets notorious stage fright. Be at peace. It will dissipate tonight. A man in this very room will be getting news of publication. I envision a rejection letter too, via mail, ironically, to the same person on the same day. Still a skeptic? You'll have to wait and see. Let me subtly say, whatever you decide to do, you'll succeed. All present are worthy of incredible things when passion is placed from within. It is in the cards for us all to have true happiness, and my ESP now tells me that the future for everyone is always uncertain. Any further discussion would prove infertile. I'd love to share more, but it looks like our time has come to a regrettable end. For those of you who believe, that'll be $50, please. Thank you.
$50. Okay. All right. I have to change the angle of the camera. I'm going to leave you with some neon.